On this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, we take a look at the differences between Xamarin Essentials Preferences API and Xamarin.Forms built-in Properties API and when you would want to use each, so tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, we're not going to dive into code. We're going to actually answer a viewer question. The question came up, which is, when would I want to use Xamarin Essentials Preferences API versus Xamarin.Forms built-in application properties dictionary? And that's a fantastic question, and I answer it a lot because I've been working with settings for like 8 years now, since I've my very first days at Xamarin. So let's hop over to the code and the documentation so I can show you when we would want to use each. So here I am inside of our App Essentials sample application I've been using for a long time. It has a nice login screen. And right here, I'm using the Preferences API as part of Xamarin Essentials. Here, I'm going to be saving out my username to the Preferences API, and I give it a default value of string. And if I want to save it, then we'll go ahead and set the value that is passed in when the user enters their username. Now, what's great about this is that this saves it into an isolated storage for iOS, Android, and UWP applications, so anything that Xamarin Essentials supports. Now, inside of this set API, if we go ahead and zoom in, we can take a look that when we went to implement it, it took only specific properties such as date, time, bool, double, float, integer, long. And this is because underneath the hood, Xamarin Essentials is using the native APIs, such as shared preferences, NS user defaults, and isolated storage on each of the different platforms. And that's important because these are set up in an isolated area, and also based on the operating system, can back up those preferences up to like iCloud or Google Drive automatically. And they'll also be restored if the user upgrades or reinstalls the application based on your settings. So preferences are great, and I've been using them for a long time. However, if you go into something such as app.current, we'll see a property here called properties. And this takes an iDictionary of anything that you possibly could want. It's an object. So if we take a look at the documentation a little bit deeper, of when you'd want to use either of these, the Xamarin.Forms properties dictionary tells you that, hey, you can store this data maybe when on start, on sleep, at different options. So here, for instance, it's casting the ID after setting the ID into the properties class. You can see that it's just a generic object, so you have to cast it here. You should also ensure that it contains it, so it's a little bit more code there. Now, this API serializes that object to disk. So if you give it really complex properties or something such as a list of string, it may fail silently because you're just storing generic data that maybe couldn't be serialized. Whereas Xamarin Essentials Preferences API is strongly typed to not only be able to set, get, remove, clear the preferences, and supports multiple data types. And like I said, these are using the underlying values of NS user default and shared preferences. Now, the important part here is that NS user default and shared preferences have special characteristics when working with wearables like Apple Watch or Android Wear applications. So here you can specify additional properties such as the suite name. So that'll enable you to share preferences between your Apple Watch and your iOS application. Moreover, when you're using this API, there's special things that light up on the platform. Both iOS and Android have built-in settings screens that you can build for your application. So here on the Android developer portal, we can see that you can build a very simple settings screen using XML as long as you're using those properties in shared preferences. So here, this key is the same key that I would specify of the string. So you could use that to build out a full settings screen for your application. And the same thing's true over here for iOS. On the Apple documentation, we can see that we can tie into the settings screen to add toggles and anything like that into it using our info plist property inside of our iOS application. So those are the two differences between those properties that are kind of generic and the Xamarin Forms specific and Xamarin Essential specific. So hopefully that cleared it up a little bit for you. If you have any questions at all, feel free to reach out. And of course, give the Preferences API a look and check out the video, which I'll link to in the show notes for the Preferences that walks you through every single bit of it. This has been yet another Xamarin Essentials API of the Week. I hope you enjoyed. Leave comments, and thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.